ensure that these things do not repeat itself.
Is there a possibility of an escalation from this, sir, given that there have been confirmed casualties on the Indian side, including a commanding officer? It doesn't get worse than that at the tactical local level. Is there a possibility that things could escalate even further from this?
The possibility is always there, but the probability is low. Like I said, the units out there, the troops out there, the leaders out there are used to handling such situations, and I'm sure they would. The probability is low, the possibility definitely is there. And that is where the higher commanders are now coming to into play out there. They're meeting each other, they're talking to each other, and they must be telling their troops, okay, we will resolve this, do your task, and we will see where to go on from here.
General Bhatia, I request you to stay on with me. I also want to go across to Lieutenant General D.B. Shiketkar, who has had much to do with the China border. He's been deployed there. He's written papers on the border dispute as well and been part of committees on the border dispute resolution. General Shiketkar, your comments, your reaction to this horrifying news from the Galwan Valley, sir. Three Indian Army personnel, including the commanding officer of the infantry battalion there, killed in clashes.
Shiv, first of all, I myself not only surprised but horrified. We never thought Chinese will go to that extent. Though I have been cautioning, I have been warning in different forums, in different way, that watch out, China will play a bigger mischief. Unfortunately, that had to happen this morning. Another unfortunate part, we lost a commanding officer, we lost a junior commissioning officer, we lost our man. There's no point comparing how many we killed and how many they died or how many they injured. The fact remains that peace and tranquility along the line of control for which the agreement was signed, I was a member of that time in 93, has been breached. Secondly, strategically talking, General Bhatia is there, he is my guru, he knows much better. One of the foreign secretary, who also happened to be the national security advisor, just last week made a mention, oh, since then we have not fired a bullet. But why didn't you be honest enough to say that without firing a single bullet, Chinese had been encroaching in your territory? In fact, when you were the advisor, that was the time your foreign minister said, this is a localized ointment, we'll apply some cream and things will be all right. The Prime Minister then said, oh, this is a localized affair, it'll get sorted out. In the warfare, in the animosity between the two countries, there is nothing localized. You don't know when things will flare up. Third point, I would request through your channel, that you are all experienced commentators on this issue, please, don't take China for granted. China has been one of the most untrustworthy nations in the world. It has not been good to anybody, and I don't think India can be an exception. Chinese have got 22 neighboring countries. Can you name one who is friend of China? Pakistan is not a friend of China. They say they are the bonded laborers of China. And the word they use, I've been listening to them, personally talking to them, I feel ashamed to speak on those words. Same goes with the North Korea. But they are worried about India. That is the point. And therefore, we should be prepared. Another philosophy of war is, if you wish to prevent a war, I repeat the word, if you wish to prevent a war, be prepared for it. If you are not prepared for war, you will get sucked into the war at the place and timing and circumstances of not your choosing. It can be Galwan, it can be Pongso, it can be finger 1, 2, 3, 4, 17, 18, 19, whatever it is. So we have to be prepared. General Bhatia will vouch for me. We have put it in writing in the report. Be prepared for war. But when you are preparing for war, we are prepared for war, don't ever be eager to go to war. But if you are not prepared, this is what will happen. Fortunately, our government at the moment is very, very firm. We are prepared for it. We have a very fine Raksha Mantri. We have the Chief of Defense Staff. We have the Army Chief, highly experienced, motivated people. And I don't think they will give up so soon. That is a saving grace. My request through your channel, Shiv,
yes,
to the nation is stand firm. My also request to those who are criticizing the government is hold on your horses. Don't open your mouth. Keep your bloody trap shut. And let's take on the Chinese first, and then you can resolve whatever you want to. Don't start issuing the statement against the government of India at the moment.
Respect your words.
I'm not the spokesperson of the government.
Respect your words very much, General Shiketkar, because you speak from the heart as a soldier, as a general, as someone who has actually dealt with these issues as far as the border dispute is concerned. You've seen this at the tactical level, you've seen this at the strategic level, and you've seen it at the positive level. So I take what you say very, very seriously, as I do with General Bhatia, who has been a Director General of Military Operations. So let there be no mistake. We always respect the veterans' view, because you have seen this in action. You don't speak just with random armchair gyan. You have seen what this is in real life, and therefore what you say carries a huge amount of weight. General Shiketkar, thank you for joining me. I'm going to try and get General Shiketkar live along with General Bhatia in just a short while from now on a Skype connection. But I want to bring in India Today's Abhishek Balla, defense editor. Abhishek, Rajnath Singh, the defense minister, about to hold a video conference with the Prime Minister. What more can you tell us? What other discussions are taking place at this point in Delhi?
Shiv, the situation is sensitive and it demands that the top leadership of the country be briefed on each and every minute detail. And that's the reason why Rajnath Singh, the defense minister himself, has been speaking to people in the security establishment. He had a meeting earlier in the day with the three service chiefs, and the chief of defense staff, General Bipin Rawat. Also present in the meeting was Foreign Affairs Minister Dr. Jaishankar. The security establishment keeping a very close watch on what's transpired in the last 14 to 15 hours. Yesterday, there was a meeting at the colonel level as well as the brigadier level in the Galwan region that to discuss de-escalation. And it's quite ironic that soon after that meeting, this ugly clash started. It's still not clear whether this clash was, in some way linked to those meetings that were taking place, or was it something completely different. But the fact remains that at a time when military commanders from both the sides have been constantly meeting, especially in the last 10 days or so, this escalation last evening has taken things to a completely different level. This is unprecedented, extremely rare. People being killed on both the sides hasn't happened in more than four decades. And that's the reason why the political leadership of the country is taking this very, very seriously. Lots of meetings taking place, reviews being done to do a ground analysis, assessment of the situation. And what I've been told is that the message to the commanders on the ground and every troop on the ground is loud and clear that there is no need to back off. And of course, the Indian Army will need to face the challenges that they are facing. And under no circumstances is there any requirement for the Indian Army to back off.
Okay, so the instructions to the troops on the ground is very, very clear. No backing off.